Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear students, we are discussing right now the rhetoric or the poetic devices. You might have heard about these words, and actually in the previous poems which we have delivered, where you guys knew about the term simile, for example, likewise metaphor, likewise assonance, etc. Today I'm gonna teach you about five important poetic devices which are present in the poem which we have discussed in the last lecture, that is My Mother 66. There are typically, I guess, some six poetic devices, five predecessors. For example, first was simile. The poet simile is, you know, to compare two things as if they are similar to each other. Here the poet compares her mother like late winter's moon and like a corpse. शायरा अपनी वालिदा को सर्दियों के चांद और एक जनाजे से तशबीह देती है. जब भी आप जानते हैं, whenever the words like is and like are present in front of a sentence, those lines are supposed to be the simile. You know it. I don't want to illustrate it more. The second is here in your poem, image. There are various images used by the poet to describe the old age of her mother. For example, he uses crops to describe death. Similarly, sprinting trees, likewise spilling boys out of their homes, etc. Image is something which you know very well. Now the thing which you are hearing for the first time is apostrophe. Dear students, one apostrophe you might have heard is the punctuation mark which is used to show something, the property of a particular person. But the apostrophe in the poetic device is something which means you are addressing a person who is not present yet. For example, you are discussing about a man and abruptly you say, "Oh, my dear friend." So that word signifies that you are addressing him who is not present yet. So all those words which shows that the poet is addressing some missing audiences is called apostrophe. For example, the word in this poem is Amma. The poetess says Amma while writing the poem. Her mother is not with her. Her mother was not with her. It signifies that she is using the apostrophe, which is a rhetorical or a poetic device. Similarly, a repetition. In the last line of the poem, you see smile, smile, smile. When a word comes again and again in just one line, it's called the poetic device repetition, which means the wordings which are used to make the rhythmic sound of the poem impressive in order to entice the reader regarding some sort of thought-provoking mentality. So that's called repetition. And the last one is personification. Personification. Dear students, personification is the poetic device by which, by using some words, we give a humanitarian embodiment to something else. Yani insani tajseem de dena. For example, hum kahenge ye aadmi to ikhlaq ka mujassam pekar hai. Ikhlaq ka mujassam pekar, yani mujassam pekar hai. In this poem, the poet has used it sprinting trees, yani uchalti kootti ya doorti hui darakhtein. To darasil darakhtein to practically are in some sort of sense empirically trees doesn't move. So she shows sprinting trees. It means the trees are running fast for a short distance, which means the poet has personified the trees as a human beings who are running very fast for a short distance. This is called personification. The sprinting trees are the personified objects of this poem. So these are the five poetic devices which are present in your poem. I have tried to elucidate them in detail, and if still you are not aware about, or you are not getting the points very clearly, just feel free to call me without any further ado. You just without any hesitation, you just give me a buzz, not to talk of a WhatsApp message, or even you can call me in order to let the problem clear for you. And this is enough for today. And as far as the other remaining questions are concerned, the textual solution, I will send them by making them as PDF through your WhatsApp, respective WhatsApp group. Don't worry and don't forget to jot down all those questions which I'm gonna send you later in your notebooks and the Poetic devices which I have explained here. I will also give the examples of Poetic device in the solution portion also. Thanks for watching this video, and I'm sure you have get the points clearly. Okay, Khuda Hafiz.